श्रीमते रामानुजाय नमः। It has been a very great subject of debate for everybody, being scientific or spiritual or social, in whatever may be the context, about the composition of each and every entity of the world. And there are innumerable interpretations for that, and I want to just project only one angular or dimensional aspect of scrutiny, which is to consider everything as jnana, that which is composed of material for knowledge, to be a source of knowledge, to be a person or viewer or observer of knowledge, to be the fruit of knowledge, which has been explained in the shastras as pramada, prameya and pramana, the tools of knowledge, gaining knowledge, and the purpose of knowledge, and that thing that is being interpreted or analyzed or identified by one's scrutiny or vision. Pramana is the tool of knowledge by which we can get the real knowledge, and pramada is a person who is a blemishless tool, who can understand that knowledge without any sort of spot or maculation. And third thing is prameya, that which is meant for being known. So everything is on the basis of knowledge, irrespective of the divisions, the depths and dimensions. Even if there is a thief, he will be interested in knowing how to make that burglary without being caught. And if even being caught, he will be very much analyzing the process by which he can be bailed out. So irrespective of the novelty, irrespective of the nobility, irrespective of the various other circumstantial variations of the society, everybody is very much oriented with knowledge, gaining blemishless, infallible information by which they can be very clear and precise in their knowing and execution. So everything is knowledge based. So the science of knowledge is known as epistemology, which has the cradle, the cot and throne in India. What is the greatness of India? That India is the real birth center, real ambrosia of the knowledge, real and perfect, all enduring, multi-dimensional, multifaceted knowledge that has originated only with land. So whenever we come to the genetics, that is the evolution of living beings, everything is subjected to growth. You know that whenever you distinguish the living and non-living creatures, we used to say that living things, they grow, and non-living things, they don't. What is that growth? Growth consists of two divisions. One is biological growth by mitosis and meiosis, which naturally happens in all living beings. Second is the psychological growth. Psychological growth is restricted with people on the basis of their spatial evaluation, on all other, starting from amoeba, ending with all other species which are subhuman in nature. The psychological growth is very much limited on the basis of their need of the survival, their flourishing, reproduction, and other very basic essentials. Whenever in human beings, there are three stages. One is that type of psychological expansion in the form of intellect, which is required for a person's survival. Second is the expansion which deals with collective survival in the form of social enhancement and scientific development. Third thing is that type of psychological growth into the form of fundamental knowledge or the study of the primitive or the primeval factor of the world by which a person's emancipation or liberation is done. So the first expansion is known as society, second expansion is known as science, and third expansion is known as spiritualism, by which a person can understand. That's what I already used to say in civilization's interpretation. Civilization is the mature stage of any human being where he can understand those who are around him, beyond him and above him. Those who are with him are surrounded, those people are considered in society. That which is beyond him is understood in science, that which is above everything is understood in spiritualism. A tri-dimensional clarity of getting an ideology about all of these things and also the practical methodology is said to be civilization, and implementation of that civilization is what we call culture. So whenever we consider it to growth, real growth is understanding about one's own self and the mutuality or the symbiosis that exists between an individual with the collective survival mechanology or mechanism. So this type of knowledge is based on various things. You know about the history and evolution of science. History that deals with three various expansions of science that is going on now. One is insufficiency of science, second is inefficiency of science, third is mismanagement of science. The first thing is, when human beings, they started involving into scientific pursuits, exemplifications, experiments and analytical studies as well as the fruits. At first they started that the science is totally inefficient because of lacking of advantage of the tools. Then the advantage of the technical era came. Then due to the evolution of various species, expansion of various problems and also the population issues, then they consider that it is insufficient. The third problem now we are facing is mismanagement of resources of the same science. We are into dealing with a new dimensional study of science in which the science has endeavored in the process of correcting its own mistakes. Number one, in order to expand the limitations that it has nailed on itself, it is going to deal with the process of getting connected sciences and advanced sciences for its own benefit. For example, if there is statistics, for getting more implementation value, you have to go for applied statistics. So in each and everything, applied, advanced, para, these prefixes are included, for example, parapsychology. So science has come to the level of understanding its mistakes, shortcomings, mismanagement and malpractices, so that it has demanded a reasonable, rational of understanding, something which is beyond human rational, that is, it needs the helpful embrace of philosophy, logic, spiritualism and realization. That is the present era wherein by we have to clearly point out essentially what is the practical dimension of philosophy. Philosophy consists of various things: fictional, fallacious, narrative, depictive, innumerable illustrious and non-illustrious and experimental and experiential visions of knowledge is there. We have to clearly deal with the empirical dimension of a conglomerated joint venture of a bilateral communion of science and spirituality in this era. And we have to start with only the process of knowledge which is being properly constituted, configured and complemented with an institutional and rational basis. That type of knowledge only will come for rescue for a long run. All the other things are just ear fillers, mind fillers and interim solace givers which will not come for any practical issue in our long run. So within the short span of the time given, I want to present everything in a nutshell. Number one, for getting knowledge there are some sources as per the shastras. One is curiosity, second is the need, third is the exposure of person, fourth is revelation. It is the curiosity of each and everybody that drills inside a person, tempts a person to go for more knowledge. A person being curious, he gets one observation, that observation gives one input. The input, if it is considered and proceeded, that becomes knowledge, otherwise it becomes just your vague experience. So first of all, it starts with curiosity. It is a persistent curiosity, directed and targeted curiosity, obedient and systematically organized logical curiosity. Second is need. Whenever your person is crushing his own mind for need of something, naturally the inner doors will be open so that the realization can be automatically brought out. Third thing is exposure. Already experienced various other inputs that he is having in his mind, whenever he is assured with that of the expansion of the society, his exposure will have a natural elasticity which will wind up its own previous stage and gives us more scope and hope for knowing some more things in the same depth, in the same direction, in the same direction or in the same dimension. So first of all, curiosity. Second is need, which brings everything. You know, in science seminar somebody told, curiosity is the mother of all inventions and necessity is the father of all inventions. Necessity is the mother of all inventions. Innumerable various definitions have been given. That's why I told in that the parentage of science can be explained like this. No doubt necessity is the mother of inventions and curiosity is the father, but danger is the daughter of all inventions now. So this is the parentage of modern science. So in this particular angular view of interpreting the reality of science, I want to say the fourth thing as a revelation. Apart from curiosity, need and also exposure of a person, revelation is an intuitive drive. Apart from what you are getting from outside, the shastras as well as even modern